Hey everyone, today I'm going to be working on this beachy area here, where the sand meets the beach, meets the ocean. And I'm just going to lighten this area up a little bit. It's a little bit too dark here and here. And I want to add a little bit more contrast so it's so the water and the land have more of a separation from each other. So it kind of stands out a little bit better. So the first thing I'm going to do is try to lighten this area up here. I already put the underpainting on. Then I'm going to use titanium white. A little bit of burnt umber. Color there, dear. We already laid out. Titanium white, a little bit of burnt umber. A little bit of Van Dyke brown. A little bit of Prussian blue and ivy black to gray down a little darker. Especially a little bit there. I would say that's about right. Brush. I'm going to fill in from here to here. I'm going to define the bottom of this pillar here. Kind of vary the colors and areas, make it a little bit darker, make it a little lighter. Put a little bit more burnt umber in places. So kind of give it a little bit more interest. Darken that area up a little bit. Okay, now I'm going to over to the other side here, and this area here is dark, and this area here is dark, and it's kind of lighter in the middle, so I'm going to put the darker areas first here. Here in the front. front, lighten that up a little bit. Kind of like a bluish white area in the middle here, so clean the brush off a little bit here. Put that in. So the same color I was mixing, just a tiny bit of blue in it too. So it kind of reflects the ocean a little bit. White. Same color, a little bit of blue. I'm going to blend it a little bit. Tiny bit, just to soften a tiny bit. See a little bit of blue in there, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a little bit of white and make it even brighter in the middle. Just put a little bit of a highlight right along the swan here. Like that. And, a little bit more. Yeah, just leave it like that. I'm not going to blend it at all. I'm just going to leave it. Kind of bright looking. Now, there's a little bit more brightness here in the back of this one. This area here. Okay. I think I want this to be a little bit darker here. Burnt umber and brown. It kind of sets that lighter area off a little bit more. Okay, that's pretty good. There's a little bit of sand showing in the middle. Here, here, here. So I'm going to put those in. Kind of that light bluish, grayish color. Here. have a real light, bluish, whitish area here. I'm going to put in here and here. There, there, and there. I'm going to take a clean brush. White. A tiny bit of that brownish color I was mixing, and blue. After it dries, I'm probably going to go back in and put some more white paint in just to make it bright as possible. So you have the pillar reflecting down a little bit of an angle, so I'm going to draw where it would be reflecting. There, I'm going to cut on here, and here. I'm going to put that nice bright white here. I'm not even going to blend it too much. I'm going to leave it as bright as I can. I want it to stand out. And this one of the bottom's a little bit bluer, so I'm going to make that a little bit less bright. Okay. I'm going to define this edge here on the top a little bit more. Reflect the ocean a little bit more on this side here, so I'm going to put a little bit more blue here. Sandbar in here, I'm going to put back in a darker brown. I'm going to find that area a little bit more. I'm going to redefine this sandbar here, so it screws a little bit more. Okay. Now, this edge here is a little bit too defined, so I'm going to soften that edge a little bit more. I think I'm getting more paint on my hands than I am on the paint. That's how it is to be an artist, though. You're always washing your hands. So I'm going to soften this edge here a little bit too defined. Okay, that looks nice, huh? Brighten that up a little bit here. Thank you. good. I wanted to hit this little boy with you. Okay, I think on my own I'm going to go back and redefine this reflection of this pillar here just to make it stand out a little bit, and I think it looks pretty good. I'm going to add a couple highlights and shadows, but I think we have something pretty good here. I notice I don't overblend it too much. What I'm doing now, whereas before I used to blend everything a little bit too much, now I'm kind of letting things kind of be the way they are, and it's a little bit better. It gives the painting a little bit more kick to it, so I kind of like to leave like that. So I think it looks pretty good here. Please be sure to visit my website at markcharlestonzillo.com, and thanks for watching.